I want to talk for this presentation about changing fingering in sequential passages, and if that seems mystifying, it will all become clear, hopefully, after it's over. One of the things that I would like to encourage you to do is to try the examples on the example sheets. And since Therese has managed to arrange viewings of the lectures online later, you can actually do something like this where you're viewing online, you listen to an explanation, you try something in your hands, see whether it makes sense, see whether you would have other ideas about what's going on. Above all, we want the idea of the Taubman work to be practical. And you're hearing a lot of dense information, which if you're hearing it for the first time may leave your head kind of spinning. We really don't want you to have that experience as much as thinking, wow, there's something here that I could use. So I'll be explaining some things on the handout today, and then you'll have a chance when you get home at a piano to try some things and say, oh, that's what he was talking about. I would say that occasionally sequences present some fingering challenges. If you can finger the notes of a sequence in the same way, that's great. But there are times when it's awkward to use the same fingering in passages that sound the same. What I'd like to do is explore why that is and see if we can come to some conclusions about how to handle these situations.